Welcome back to River City Live. So we're actually going to talk about how video games affect the psyche and the mental well-being of everybody. But I found out that we're also going to say that there are some positives here. So Dr. Tracy Alloway, who is a great guest to have because you cover so many different areas from memory to people's reaction to things that are stimulating them. And this video game thing, it's a big deal.
I talk about it all the time because my kids are on, and again, I'm trying to monitor it, but I don't think I'm doing a good job. So it was one of the things that we were talking about. I'm like, can we reach out to Tracy?
I'm so excited to be here because you're right, it is such a big topic. And the research, there's such a growing amount of research on this topic. And we do know that the brain actually changes, not just functionally, as in how it's working, but also structurally when we engage in video game, in gaming. One of the things, there are two positives. First of all, researchers have found when they look at brain imaging that it actually changes the way we use attention. We're more attentive, which is maybe contrary to what we might think. The second positive benefit of that is that it also increases our hippocampus, and that's associated with our spatial skills. So, you know, when someone says, I can never navigate, I always get lost, was that a right turn or left turn? You know, that's your hippocampus kind of maybe malfunctioning on you. But research has found that gaming can actually increase the size of it, so those structural changes. Now, the caveat in all of this is that all of these research studies look at gaming in short periods of time, 20, 30 minutes a day, maybe 3 days a week over a few week period, not 3 hours where you're just kind of glued onto the screen or your tablet or so on. But I know we were talking about Fortnite a bit earlier too.
Yeah. Well, you know, that came on the scene about a year ago, and really it took the entire population from people,
grown-ups
to kids.
Yes.
And they're on there, you know, constantly. Mm-hmm. So I think that's an area of concern because there's so much time, and really kids just lose track of time. Mm-hmm. And then the other thing too is everything on devices, because it increases the amount of screen time you get because you can bring it anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and there's a couple things, because like you mentioned, Mark, it's come out over a year ago. There's been enough chance for researchers to catch up a little bit and see what's happening. So a couple things have been reported. One is this idea of a near-miss effect. Because of the way the game is structured, a lot of the rewards are random. And so our human behavior, our instinct is to try to find a pattern. So if I just kind of throw candy along the floor, you want to know, what's her pattern? Why is she putting candy here, here, and here? And that's kind of what's happening in the gaming environment, which is very addictive. So people want to keep playing and say, hey, I found a reward in this treasure box and that, but not there. So what's going on? But it also provides a sense of near miss, which is something gamblers experience too, which is you get the same sense of satisfaction and feel good hormones just by nearly being successful. So you don't actually have to be successful at the level. You get that rush, and which is going to encourage you to play again.
How does that translate into a negative in the real world?
And that's where that addiction comes in. But I would say that, again, with caution. So the World Health Organization last summer introduced a gaming disorder classification. And this was met with huge outcry, not just from the public, but also clinicians, psychologists, and so on, because really any addictive behavior, to be classified as being addictive, it has to actually interfere with everyday life that you can actually function. So while as a parent, you might be thinking, I don't want them to spend an hour every day doing that. Is it actually affecting them where they can't go to sleep because they just want to sneak out and play that game again? Is it affecting them to the point that they don't want to socialize outside that gaming environment? Those are some indices to look for.
I feel like with a lot of addictions, there's a functioning alcoholic, and there's ways to, you have a problem, but yet you could still do your task. Mm-hmm. I feel like with gaming, though, some kids have it for 3 to 4 to 5 hours a day, so they could still do their schoolwork, but it's carving into other things.
That's right.
Family time, talking, you know, actually having communication, getting out in the backyard or a sporting event. So that's where I say long term, where it could have an effect.
So how do you find that balance? So you want to allow them to play and maybe even have some experience that benefits them, but you don't want them to become addicted.
Yeah, that's great. And so some parents have intervened by being part of the gaming environment with them. So I do know some father-son combos that will play the game together, and they develop these complementary skills. So for survival, you know, the dad has this skill in Fortnite specifically, and the son brings in this game. So it's a way for them to connect, in as much as, you know, maybe watching Monday Night Football. Is it Monday nights? Just checking.
Yeah. Football game of some sort. Any day.
Sports ball.
Yeah. Thanks for covering me, Eden. But essentially just a way to connect. And so that's one thing that you could do. And a second is, like you mentioned, Mark, setting limits. So just saying, hey, and people do this anyway with game, you know, with iPads or movie time or screen time. You have 30 minutes and then we're going to stop and do something else. So,
well, I know this is something that we could go on and on and on about. Yeah. Tracy is a UNF professor of psychology as well as an author, and she has written so many very fascinating books for kids, for adults, mm-hmm. for people concerned about their memory. And I think anywhere books are sold, Amazon.
It's on Amazon.
Dr. Tracy Alloway, and we look forward to having you back because you always enlighten us.
I love being here. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.